Dear students, it is the fourth lecture into the series, and today we are going to talk about the research synthesis and its guidelines. What exactly the research synthesis is? Research synthesis is defined as the integration of research findings and existing knowledge related to a problem. Right? We are looking for the research on some problem, and some findings we have generated from us, but there is already some existing knowledge is there, right? So we are going to integrate the existing knowledge as well as our results with that. That is known as the research synthesis. Research synthesis has basically the multiple components like systematic review, meta-analysis, expert elicitation, and why analysis, right? In the next slides, we shall understand about these things in detail. So first we shall study about the systematic review. Systematic review is to deliver the summary of all available primary research in response to a research question. Right? Some research question has come to us, and whatever the research has already been done into that particular area, we shall collect all the summary of that, and we'll go for the further processing. It uses all available existing research. Therefore, it is also known as the secondary research. Whatever the research has already undergone and that is known to us, right? So that existing research is to be compiled for the systematic review. It utilizes the research evidences through identifying the problem, selecting, synthesizing, and appraising. These are the four different components which are very much important for the systematic view. We just have to identify exactly what type of the existing research is going to be included and what is relevant to it. Then, after identification, selection is there, right? It is really practical. It is not feasible to use all the existing research. That's why we want to select which are very close to our research, and only then we go for that. Then we should synthesize. Synthesis means we just to analyze exactly that whatever the methodology they have used, whatever the conclusion they have done, whatever. The research question was there, that is another thing, and after that appraisal, and we have to go ahead with that if required. On the next part, the second part is the meta-analysis. Meta-analysis is also known as the studies about the studies. Whatever the study has already been done, we have to again study into the different perspective. Right? It is quantitative formal study design used to systematically assess the available research results to drive conclusion about components of research. A very common example what we used whenever we talk to some of the students, if there is a glass half filled with the water, so someone will say that is it half filled with the water, someone will say it is half empty. Someone saying it is half filled with water and half filled with air. Different type of the analysis can be generated from the same situation, right? So this particular type of the things are known as the meta-analysis. It emphasizes the practical importance rather than the statistical significance. Hardly whatever the statistical results are going to come, it is the accuracy is 90%, since it is highly specific, it is highly sensitive or not sensitive. Whatever the type of things are there, that is not important for at all for the meta-analysis. It is only emphasizing on the practical importance of the particular situation. Then there is the expert elicitation. It is rarely used, and in rare events it is going to be used. It synthesizes the opinion of the various authors when there is uncertainty about the data is insufficient. Nowadays it is very common because in the COVID-19 situations, it's a very new situation which has been generated just 1 year back, and the research it takes a lot of time, right? The vaccine, if we compare with the other pandemics, whatever came in on the earth before it, the vaccine has come too early because it took a very small span of time, of almost less than 1 year. The vaccine has been generated for that thanks to the technology. Whatever the thing is there, after the vaccine has been come, or whether we have to wear the mask, or we have to maintain the physical distances, whether vaccine COVID is deadly or not, different type of opinions you are seeing here in the social media, on the newspapers, on the television, from the different speakers, right? To whatever the reason, we have to synthesize exactly about the opinion, whether that opinion is correct, whether that is on the fact base, whether that is logical or not, and that is known as the expert elicitation. Right, that is being basically done by the experts of that particular area only. Then there is the why analysis. It is a very interesting component of the research or the systematic review. It is usually used to search the root cause of the problem. What exactly the problem is, what is the root cause, what we have to come to know about the why analysis. Usually 5 whys are sufficient to go for it. That's why it is also known as the 5 why analysis. Just like for an example, if it says, yes, I am suffering from flu. Okay, I've said something to you. Question: why are you suffering from the flu? Because I consumed ice cold water and it affected me. And why you consume the ice cold water? It was very hot. So why are you not, you are into the hot area, and so on. Such type of things we are going to come, and we should come to know about the why analysis. Such type of things are commonly happen with us. Usually our parents, our elders, our teachers, our friends are used to come to know whenever we see them the problem, they ask why, right? Why, how, then one set of why, usually up to 4 to 5 whys, we get exactly the root cause of the problem. It is widely used by the psychologist to come to know about the problems of their patients during the counseling process also. Right, so why analysis is an important whenever the root cause of the problem is not known to us. And it gives us a good estimation of the root cause of the problem. Research synthesis, who has to do the research synthesis, by whom? There may be an individual researcher, just like whenever we talk about the counseling sessions, right, whatever I mentioned in my previous slide, the psychologist, individual researcher is sufficient for that. There can be a working groups, like we are talking about this COVID-like situation. The working groups, there are the multiple scientists who are working on this, there are the multiple analysts who are working on this, there are multiple people, even including we are also doing the research on this. And nowadays, daily we come about the different opinions, we think about that, we implement, we don't implement, and a lot of things are there. And there are the expert working groups are there. In working groups, we people may come into that category. In the expert working groups, there may be the doctors, there may be scientists. If I will talk about the expert working group, basically you can say the subset of the working groups only, right? Where the person with the expertise in that particular area will give its opinion about the research synthesis process, whatever we have explained earlier. And the next one we use is the evidence-based practice. It's a next topic, and it is idea to practice the occupation by practitioners on basis of the scientific evidences. That is widely used into the healthcare. Doctors, whatever theirs, you are having the RTE infection, take it in some other medicine. Whatever the medicine is, there are some specific medicines. What we turn into the respiratory tract infection. Now, if we go for the expert, if you the upper respiratory tract infection or the lower respiratory tract infection. Right. So in healthcare research, evidence-based practice is on the very outside, which particular medicine will be useful for it. Right. It minimizes the irrelevant, unethical, and the wasteful research. Because whenever the established facts are there or the evidences are available there, we have to go for the implement into that, and we have to go start our the next research from there only. Instead of starting from the scratch, wherever the research has been left by someone, we have to start from here. In social sciences, it is widely used, it is education, in wherever you see, in we go for the literature review. Basically, it is a good thing to know about the evidences, and evidence practice is on very higher side, and it should be used for to save your time to give a good impact of your results, to your research results, and to minimize the irrelevant and unethical research. Thank you very much. You may ask your questions into discussion forum. We request you to submit your quick within deadline as and when it is last. Thank you.